I didn't even know what to think. I didn't know what to expect. He's a kid and he was innocent.
He's in a cage. If you put teenagers in that situation, you're damaging them for life.
There was no way I was gonna walk out of jail and all of a sudden decide to turn my life around. There was no way.
I see those young men in prisons, and I think to myself, they could be me.
He was cool. He's my brother. He was my youngest brother too. We were boys, so like we play fight, but at the same time we like considered ourselves like superheroes and like we were like Dragon Ball characters.
New York, where dreams are made. For some. But for the children locked up here, New York is a nightmare. This is Rikers Island, a notorious New York jail complex between Queens and the Bronx.
The first thing you notice is the smell. Everything smells like urine. Everything.
On any day, 15,000 prisoners are held here, including children. More than 3 years behind bars is an horrific thought. But imagine if 2 years of that was spent all alone with little or no human contact. You're 16, you're imprisoned because someone says you stole a backpack. You say you didn't. Welcome to Khalif Browder's life. He turned 17 in jail. He was still there for his 18th birthday and his 19th, as well as his 20th.
So this is Khalif?
Yeah.
It's a nice photo.
His brother Akeem feels Khalif was robbed of his childhood.
Missed out on RJ being born. Athena being born.
Is it his nieces and nephews?
Yep. You missed out on, like, a lot that...
Well, 3 years of his life, right?
Yeah. And a lot happens in 3 years if you don't, like, if you really don't think about it. If you really think about it, there's a lot that happens.
Akeem's little brother, Khalif, had his cash bail set at $3,000. Their single mother couldn't afford that, or a lawyer. So Khalif stayed in jail for more than 1,000 days.
Khalif, or if any adolescent committed a crime, there's a clear designation between adult and adolescent. So, I mean, why treat him like an adult?
New York is one of two states in the US still convicting and prosecuting 16-year-olds as adults.
I thought, he's a kid, they gotta let him go, actually, because, like, he's 16 years old.
They didn't. What they did was lock him in solitary confinement for 800 days.
He's in a cage. And then, not only are you isolated, but you have handcuffs and shackles. So you're an animal. It was meant as a torture tactic.
A tactic that's concerned President Obama. In his final year in the White House, he's taking a stand so others don't suffer as Khalif did.
In the latter part of his tenure, President Obama has put criminal justice reform high on his agenda.
Solitary confinement for children is a breach of the UN Human Rights Convention. So Obama's using his executive power to try to end solitary for juveniles. But the problem is, Obama's mandate only applies to federal prisons. Most American jails are run by local authorities, including Rikers Island.
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you as well.
Thanks for making the time. We really appreciate it. Really appreciate it.
Rikers has one of the highest rates of solitary in America.
Okay, thanks, Noel. I'm just going to move on.
To find out why, I sat down with the boss of the New York Corrections Officers Union, who told me that solitary is necessary, even for juveniles.
They've tried to relax the rules on solitary confinement for people under the age of 21, haven't they? In line with human rights, though, around the world. Do you disagree with that policy?
I don't disagree with laxing it when it comes to certain violations of the policies and procedures. But what do you do with an inmate that slashes the face of a correction officer, or rapes an inmate, or attempts to rape a correction officer, or kills, maims another inmate? What do you do with that inmate? Where do you put that inmate? Do you allow this inmate to continue to roam the corridors of the jail system as Hannibal Lecter would do?
Would you describe Rikers as a torture chamber?
Those that have described it as a torture chamber are those that have a gripe, a grievance. I would describe it as more of a camp right now, and it wasn't bad. It's not an environment where, you know, we're hanging people by their toenails.
This security footage clearly shows Khalif being beaten repeatedly. Rikers is known for its culture of violence. Only 1 in 10 people can afford to pay bail in New York, so plenty of teens end up here. Kids accused of minor infractions like travelling without a subway ticket, held alongside serious offenders. When Khalif wasn't locked up in solitary, his days were spent here with the masses. Whilst no one is saying Khalif was a model prisoner, he was kept in jail because prosecutors kept arguing they needed more time. They delayed his court case more than 30 times. They did offer to release him if he pled guilty. But not wanting a permanent criminal record, he refused, protesting his innocence for the entire 3 years. His torturous period locked up eventually ended when the prosecution couldn't produce a witness.
Khalif was damaged. He didn't go there damaged. He was then damaged. It was tragic that my brother went through this, that he was innocent.
A huge majority of young people behind bars here in New York are from just a handful of neighborhoods, low socioeconomic neighborhoods like this one, the Bronx, and Harlem. And what's worse is that 70% of teens who are tried and convicted as adults will end up back behind bars later in life.
It's no joke when you hear your friends telling you that you're gonna end up in juvie or dead before you're 18.
Sasha grew up in a New York suburb where a third of people live below the poverty line. She was arrested by police for assault, and she ended up here. Youth court is an alternative. Here, teens are judged by their peers instead of facing a traditional court. The goal is to prevent future involvement with the criminal justice system.
That day, I had no idea what youth court was. I walked in and I saw a kid coming up to me saying, hey, I'm going to represent you, and I just laughed.
Youth court is run by children for children. Nikes, hoodies and all. Police refer low-level juvenile crimes here, like skipping school, punch-ups, and offences like what Khalif was accused of doing, stealing a backpack.
left, I was like, what the hell is this? Like, a kid's representing me? Okay, like, this should be funny.
I solemnly swear or affirm.
I solemnly swear or affirm.
And I was with my dad, and my dad was like, behave yourself. Like, I'm just saying, what type of court has kids representing kids?
Issue before the court, truancy.
Does the jury have any questions?
Yes, but just to let you know, we're here to help you, not to judge you. So please tell me what happened on the day of the offense.
And while the process kind of looks like a play dress rehearsal,
is this your first offense?
Yeah.
This is actually a real court with real consequences.
Is there anything else you'd like to say on your behalf?
No.
Thank you, you may sit down.
And what I really love about them is that they're ordinary teenagers horsing around, listening to music. They put on the shirts for youth court, and they're dead serious, and you don't mess with them.
Judge Calabrese runs youth court in Red Hook, which is a poorer part of New York.
When I first came, the people at Red Hook had gone through so many murders per year, so many robberies, so many assaults per year. We had a community that was under siege. Literally on a daily basis, they were scared and they were terrified. It was a community where when the gunfire was particularly difficult at night, you put your children to bed in the bathtub because that was the safest place. And if you lived on the first floor of the Red Hook houses, you taught your children when they heard a bang to hit the floor. Bang, hit the floor.
Okay, don't forget, you gotta check in upstairs.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He believes youth court helps prevent teens becoming trapped in the cycle of court, prison, and poverty.
In the traditional court, the same people who I see recycling in and out of jail time and time and time again are people that I know we can help them get their lives back on track, have them be successful, have them graduate, have them smiling, relinking them with their family. It's a whole different result.
Now your lawyer says you wish to enter a plea of guilty to VTL 11921.
For more than a decade, he's split his time between here and training the kids who run youth court.
You can go to jail for 15 days. Do you understand?
Yes. Is there anything else you'd like to say or want to have?
I'm really sorry.
The youth judge, jury, and prosecutors pride themselves on genuinely listening to fellow teens' stories.
Well, if a younger youth was in the same situation as you, what advice would you give them?
I'd tell them not to do it because the past will haunt you.
The jury has no further questions.
All right, so do you guys think he deserves a sanction?
He said he wanted to apologize to someone, so maybe just a better apology.
But he did. He tried to, but he wasn't there.
He wasn't successful.
Do you think we should give him a sanction or just a reminder?
Just a letter of apology.
You have a 16-year-old, you can incarcerate that child for a year or two. The kid's going to get at 18 and will have lost all schooling, lost all contact with the family. It's not going to be a good result for the community in the end.
In the communities where it's available, the alternative justice that youth court provides has been hugely successful.
We had a kid 2 years ago get a 4-year scholarship to an Ivy League college. That just didn't happen at a Red Hook.
Khalif, sadly, wasn't given the youth court option.
I think anything different would have saved him. That sounds really positive, to have peers of your own age judge you.
I was known for being a good player. Like, I would come on the court, everybody would forget about what happened earlier that day, who I was arguing with. It would just be like, oh look, Sauce is playing. Let's go to the game.
Basketball has always been an outlet for Sasha's anger.
I'm punching. I don't catfight. I don't pull the hair. No. We would fight.
Proper fight.
Proper fight.
Yeah. Fighting at school's nothing new. But in New York, the law means that making a mistake as a teenager can change and even ruin futures. Sasha assaulted a classmate so badly, she was arrested.
Next day I went to school, the police were waiting for me. I never even made it to my second period class.
With the benefit of hindsight, do you see that you were spiraling downhill?
I do.
I definitely do. And it was at the point where my mother couldn't even look at me the same because she didn't know who I was anymore. She had no idea. She was like, this isn't the Sasha I raised. When I got sent here, she was so disappointed in me that her comment towards me was, if they ask about your mother, tell them you do not have one.
Which means that I will not reveal or discuss anything that occurs during this youth court hearing with anyone.
Sasha was sentenced by her peers at youth court instead of a normal, harsher court that could have sent her behind bars.
I saw the process. I was like, oh, this really isn't a joke that, you know, they take things seriously here.
Good afternoon, judge, guests, and members of the court.
The teen judge and jury listened to her and decided on balance she'd been provoked into assaulting her classmate. She was still punished with community service and an anger management course.
Has the jury determined the sanction?
Yes.
Afterwards, they came out and they said, hey, look, would you like to become a member of youth court? And I knew that I was very interested in this when we took our exam towards the ending of training to become a member, and I was the one with the highest test score. And I was like, wow, like, I surprised myself. It's like, wow.
You're starting to do pretty well. Now you have to give it into the basics.
Pretty well. You sound surprised.
No, because that's the first time you're making eggs like that, the beat up eggs.
They taste good.
Yeah.
Sasha's mum and dad believe youth court saved their daughter's life.
I really believe my daughter was going to die the way she got into anger crying. When she gets here, I said, I have to be here.
So what would you say your biggest fear at that time was?
That lately, the children, as soon as they become high school kids, they're being treated and taught of as adults, like they're not supposed to make mistakes anymore. And that was one of my fears. Think about it, compared to arrested, precinct, lockup, juvenile, for what? You understand what I mean? Where is it gonna get them? You just shortening their whole future. That's it. You just took a petty thing that could be turned around and just send them in a whole direction of criminality.
The path that she chose to go wrong, that's it. I wasn't going to be part of it. Or part of her life. And
it's emotional for you too.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because I know how much I hurt them. I never really told them how sorry I was.
But she did. She did make up for it. It's more than enough. You know? It's okay.
It is an outrageous case.
Khalif Browder, a New York man who spent 3 years behind bars, has committed suicide.
2 years after his release from jail, Khalif Browder hanged himself with an air conditioner cord in his home in the Bronx.
I got there and then Raheem pulled me to the backyard and I couldn't even, I was like, but where is he? Like, where is he? Like, I got to see him, but I never got to see him because they had pulled the body out before I got there. And
tell us about your future dreams now.
My future dreams, I'm going to be a prosecutor in criminal law. From there, I will do my 10 years, become a judge. And from judge, I would like to run as state general attorney.
So this is a 30-year plan?
Yes.
Judge Calabrese's youth court and community justice ideas have been so successful, it's been adopted in Australia and elsewhere around the world.
He's awesome. He really is. He actually wants me to intern with him when I get back into school.
Hey.
Hi, Judge
Calabrese. How you doing?
I'm fine. And yourself?
Good to see you.
Good
really
to
great
see you
to see
also.
You. Hey, take a seat. I want to catch up with you.
He will give you a fair chance.
So
and I admire that because I've met judges that aren't like that. They feel that as a youth, you have to be perfect. Because as you know, I do want to be a lawyer.
And you'd be a great judge because you'd bring that balance and that experience too. And we need people like you who understand, who bring a whole world of experience to the bench. We definitely need that. It makes judges more effective. And when judges are more effective, the community understands and believes that the court cares about them.
And while Sasha's path now seems a lot clearer, change still needs to filter across all of New York. Akeem is determined it will, eventually.
So I'm gonna pull up the email for a campaign to shut down Rikers. It says Rikers is a waste of public spending. It costs $167,731,000 to detain a person for 1 year.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah.
He's campaigning to change the system that stole his baby brother.
Akeem is one of the co-founders for the campaign to shut down Rikers. With that, Akeem will begin.
Thank you everyone for coming. Khalif, before any of this happened, he was not a mentally disturbed or distressed child, not at all. And so to the transformation of what happened in time actually made him not recognizable to us as a family member, but at the same time, he was a child.
Justice!
Fed up with the system, filmmaker Quentin Tarantino joined others protesting with families who want to prevent more tragedy. There's growing discontent right across New York about Rikers, brutality, and the laws imprisoning kids as adults.
We want freedom, freedom, all these racist ass cops. We want freedom, freedom.
I want to see change. I want to see change in how we judge.
We don't need them, need them.
The law is innocent until proven guilty. What's so hard about doing that?